Can I have your attention, please? Welcome to the 2017 swearing in of constitutional officers for Pinellas County. I want to begin, so I don't forget, by thanking our clerk, Ken Burke, for putting this together. He was so worried he even wrote a script for me so I wouldn't mess up. But anyway, the constitutional officers in Florida are found in two different articles of the Florida Constitution, Article 5 and Article 8. In Article 5, you find our learned judges, our state attorney, and our public defender. In Article 8, you find the locals, the sheriff, the tax collector, property appraiser, clerk of court, who'd I forget? And the supervisor of elections. Because none of us would be here but for the supervisor of elections. At this time, I'd like to introduce Pam Dubov, our outgoing property appraiser. As many of you know, Pam has decided to embark on a new phase of her life. She's become a minister in the Methodist Church, and she served us for 8 years as the elected property appraiser, and for several years before that as the chief deputy. So, Reverend Dubov, would you come and give the invocation?
Thanks for not giggling too much when you heard that. I still do.
Friends, let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, we gather together this evening for a very special occasion, and we thank you for your presence with us. Tonight, gentlemen and a wonderful lady who serve our community will take the oath of office to continue to serve in capacities that challenge them every day. In addition, we will swear in two new constitutional officers, Carlos Thomas and Mike Twitty. As these six wonderful public servants move forward into another term or a new term of office, we ask that you grace them with your presence each and every day, that you fulfill them and instill in them a love for public service, that you guide their steps to remember that although the majority rules, the vulnerable, the minority, those not in the majority still need a voice. We thank you this evening for the people from their staffs, from their families, and especially their spouses who are here to support them. We all know that lives in public service can involve long hours, unexpected surprises, times of challenge and trial, and without our families, it would be very difficult for any of us who serve the public to make it through each day. We thank you for the presence of our two state senators, Senator Latvala and Senator Brandis. We're so grateful to have gentlemen like them in Tallahassee looking out not only for what is good for our state, but what's good for here in Pinellas County. On this day, as these men and women are sworn in, I ask that you guide their paths in the year ahead and let everyone here present who works in local government or state government remember always that the people we serve count on us to do the right thing every day. Keep that the watchword as we do our duties. Bless this wonderful community that you have given us, this piece of creation that we call home. God bless Pinellas County and the men and women who are about to be sworn in. I pray this prayer in your holy name. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Pam. Now I'd ask everybody to stand and welcome the chair of the Pinellas County Commission, Janet Long, who will lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
Thank you. Please join me.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Would you please be seated? Mr. Burke kindly gave me permission to offer a few remarks, and so I was very proud to do so. In thinking about what I would like to share with all of you, and especially to our two new public servants this evening, it seemed appropriate to share a few words from a former legislator some of you may remember, Bill Sadowski. Bill Sadowski left the legislature in 1992. He wrote these words for freshman members of the Dade County delegation. As words to live by, they remain relevant to every elected official today, and I offer them to you to think about as you enter your new roles as public servants for Pinellas County government. Bill Sadowski died in 1992 in an airplane crash while serving as Florida's Secretary of Community Affairs. An affordable housing program was enacted in his honor and named in his memory, the Sadowski Trust Funds. His words were, "Always respect another person's right to hold their own views, just as you want others to respect your right to hold their independent views. Don't question people's motivations. Consider what they say on the merits. A good idea from a scoundrel is still a good idea." Lobbyists are citizens or represent citizens who are exercising their constitutionally protected right to seek redress for grievances. It's an important right, so respect it. Avoid publicly committing to a position on an issue until you have a satisfactory understanding of the issue and its implications. If an issue is significant, you owe it to your constituents and yourself to affirmatively seek information relevant to your decision. Avoid taking a position on an issue until you have talked to persons on both sides of the issue. Consult staff or other electeds and citizens who are conversant with an issue. Universities are excellent sources of information and advice. Once you take a position, don't change it unless there is a compelling, rational reason to do so. Do not feel compelled to take a firm position on an issue simply because somebody wants you to. You will gain respect if you candidly admit to a lack of knowledge of an issue and promise to acquire the knowledge and follow through with that promise. Do not rely on others to adequately educate you on an issue. They will frequently have a bias. Rely on your own efforts and educate yourself. After all, it's your public decisions upon which others will judge your performance. Hear people out on an issue and then make an independent decision on it. But don't be afraid to test out your conclusions with colleagues or with staff. Elected officials make their worst decisions when they ignore the benefits of effective competing advocacy on an issue. Your satisfaction, mastery of, and effectiveness in the political process will be a function of the amount of time, effort, and enthusiasm that you put into the job. Remember at all times that an elected official is merely a citizen who, for a limited period of time, is granted a modest portion of government's power. You are but a temporary part of government. Moreover, never forget that the people in their constitution and charter retained all political power themselves. Your power and responsibilities, along with those of other branches of government, are defined by the people in the Constitution and the Charter of Pinellas County. Your existence as an elected official arises solely from that document. Read the document and know it. It is a living document. Don't forget the people. In addition to granting power to the branches of government, also declare certain protections for themselves. Be sensitive to those protections, such as their rights to be free from unreasonable government interference and to freedom of speech and association, and do not violate them. Public office is a public trust, both legally and conceptually. Never violate that trust. Your family is a source of strength and a point of real contact. Preserve and protect that strength at all cost. An elected official's world in many ways can be artificial. Don't lose touch with the real world. You have two constituencies, two. That one that elects you and one that you serve. The one that you serve consists of all the citizens in Pinellas County. You are a politician in a democracy. Take pride in that. Use your office to generate public debate on important issues of the day. I hope these words are as profound for you as they have been for me in the years that I have been in public service in this county. Thank you.
Thank you, Janet. Now, please welcome Valerie Fuzz of Real Estate Management, and please rise again. I'm sorry. And she will sing our national anthem.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming.
That's the best part so far, hate to say it. And I have a list of special guests, commonly called the list of dignitaries. And Mr. Burke has asked that everyone hold their applause till everyone is recognized. It's a good idea anyway, Ken. Our esteemed Senator Jack Latvala, and our esteemed Senator, Jeff Brandis, who got up. Several judges are here. Chief Judge Anthony Rondolino, Judge Tris Muscarella, County Judge Miriam Missouri, Judge Keith Meyer, Judge Josh Reba, and the judges pair, Deanna and Crockett Farnell. Let's stop there and give all those a hand. Also, we have former Sheriff Jim Coates, former property appraiser Pam Dubov, Janet Long, you've met, Commissioner Dave Eggers of the County Commissioners here, Commissioner Karen Seal, St. Petersburg City Councilman Ed Montaneri was noticed, and Clearwater City Councilman Bill Johnson. In addition, we have some Pinellas County folks, Director of Human Resources Holly Schorner, County Attorney Jim Bennett, Chief Assistant County Attorney Jewel White, Director of the Construction Licensing Board Rod Fisher, our County Administrator Mark Woodard, Director of the BTS or Business Technology Services Marty Rose, and Executive Director of Forward Pinellas Whit Blanton, and Director of the Office of Human Rights Paul Valenti. Let's give all those folks a nice hand. Now, are there any dignitaries I missed that want to identify themselves? Seeing none, let's move on to the program. Our first greetings will come from the Honorable Jeff Brandis, Florida State Senate. Jeff?
And I know we have many greetings, so I'll be brief. So friends, members of the jury, it's truly an honor to be with you tonight and exciting to be part of this. I've been here for 6 years now, and this is my first opportunity to watch a swearing in of constitutional officers. You know, we're about to enter into another session, which means for us it's kind of appropriation season. So every few minutes now, we have a new group coming into our office asking for new things and new opportunities. And we've really distilled most conversations down to two things. What's your vision and who's your champion? And so, I think my guidance and greeting tonight is that the Constitution lays out the vision for your positions, but the electors and the constituents have nominated you and have asked you to serve as their champion. And so I look forward to working with you. I truly appreciate the opportunity and the guidance that you all have provided me for the last many years, and look forward to your counsel as we look to continue to make Pinellas County the greatest place to live, work, and play in the great state of Florida. God bless you. Thank you so much for having me.
Next, someone who's no stranger to any of us here, the chair of the Pinellas County Legislative Delegation and one of the leaders in the state of Florida, Senator Jack Latvala.
Thank you very much. Where was my script? Well, I guess you didn't think it would work anyway, right? Thank you very much for the honor of being here today. Most of you know that I love Pinellas County very much. It's hard for me to believe that this is the first time I've ever been involved in one of these ceremonies, but I certainly want to take a moment to honor each one of the people that we're swearing in today. I'm going to start with the person that invited me because, I get invited to do a lot of things, but I think this is the first time I've ever been invited to swear anybody in. I've sworn at him, so I guess he thought it'd be appropriate for me to swear him in. But Ken, as you start your fourth term here, and having the ability to work with you in Tallahassee, see the leadership you provide for all the clerks around the state, we're very, very fortunate to have you. Our senior elected official, who I think is being sworn in for his 14th or 15th term today, my very, very good friend, our state attorney, who is, it's just really kind of amazing that I could live in Pinellas County as long as I have. Bernie has been the state attorney or did the state attorney's work for all those years. And, never a hint of scandal or impropriety in that office, and I'm so proud of you. Thank you, Bernie, very much. Bob Dillinger, our public defender, just a wonderful man, has broken new ground in what public defenders do all over the state of Florida. You know, it used to be that public defenders looked on their job as, you know, they go in and they represent the guilty one in court. But Bob has taken one step beyond that and trying to solve some of the problems with mental illness and substance abuse problems that brings people to court to start with. And it's just remarkable some of the things that Bob Dillinger has been able to accomplish. Deb Clark, I had the opportunity to advocate for you when Governor Bush appointed you when I was in the Senate before. A wonderful friend, a wonderful public servant. Even if I don't like all those people voting absentee, you know, I love the job that you've done and the way you've done it to the best of your ability as our supervisor, and we're proud of you. Our two newbies both have big shoes to fill. I'm going to start with the one that has to fill the shoes of our newest clergy, member of the clergy, Pam Dubov, my old friend who I helped get elected when that time came, who never really asked my opinion about becoming a clergyman. I guess figured that I probably wouldn't know much about that, has gone on to a calling that we all need to acknowledge and appreciate very much, much, much more important calling than anything that we as elected officials do. Carlos, represent my, and Mike, that, I'm sorry, and Mike, you're filling those shoes, and we appreciate you. Carlos, I don't know where Diane is today. I would have expected that Diane would be here, because she's always been here, as long as I can remember, both as a deputy tax collector and then as a tax collector. But you've learned from the best, and you've learned from one of the most humble public officials we've ever had in this county. You know, she's just set a great example for the rest of us, and also as president of the state association and so forth, she's been a real leader from Pinellas County. We've had a lot of leaders come from Pinellas County, and we need to continue that. It's my privilege to serve with the county commissioners that you have, with Senator Brandis. I haven't quite got him doing everything I want him to do yet, but we're working on it, and he'll learn someday. But you know, we all love this county, we all work together, and we set an example for others around the state of how local elected officials should work with legislators, and it's my privilege to be part of the group. Thank you.
Senator Latvala's comments are always memorable and provocative. He mentioned some ancient history here. Well, I'm going to ask you to all go back in time and remember where you were in 1972. Let's think about the Tampa Bay area. In 1972, we had no Buccaneers, no Rays, no Lightning. Nationwide, Richard Nixon just won a landslide election, winning 49 of 50 states. The movie The Godfather came out that year, which may be symbolic of something in the future I'm going to mention here. The TV show MASH came out that year. And the song of the year was by Carole King, and it was You've Got a Friend. Well, Pinellas and Pasco County got a great friend that year in 1972, because that's the year a young law school graduate from Stetson University went to work for the 6th Judicial Circuit State Attorney, Mr. Jimmy Russell. And that man, of course, is our current State Attorney, Bernie McCabe. Since 1972, he's been serving the people of these two counties. And in 1993, he got elected to the main position as our state attorney and took office that year. So he is going on 45 years of service to the people of Pinellas and Pasco County. And as Senator Latvala says, and he's quite right in this, I would never disagree with the good senator, that
Bernie McCabe is just, you don't realize it until you're part of the system, is how well recognized he is statewide for his leadership on all types of criminal justice issues. He is highly regarded. He's often called on by the governor to serve in different capacities, by various governors to serve in different capacities. And we are truly blessed to have him serve as our state attorney here in Pinellas and Pasco County. I now call forward our state attorney, Bernie McCabe, and ask his wife, Denise, to please come forward. And I will ask our chief judge, Anthony Rondolino, to please come forward and to administer the oath of office to our state attorney, Mr. McCabe.
Standing in front of that one. Okay. And she's going to hold the Bible for you.
I figured that.
All right, if you'll place your left hand on the Bible and raise your right hand. I've been waiting over 40 years to get him under oath. All right. I state your name.
I, Bernie McCabe.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support, protect, and defend.
That I will support, protect, and defend.
The Constitution and government of the United States.
The Constitution and government of the United States.
And of the state of Florida.
And of the state of Florida.
That I am duly qualified to hold office.
That I am duly qualified to hold office.
Under the Constitution of the state.
Under the Constitution of the state.
And that I will well and faithfully perform.
And that I will well and faithfully perform
the duties of State Attorney of the Sixth Judicial Circuit.
The duties of State Attorney of the Sixth Judicial Circuit.
Upon which I am now about to enter.
Upon which I am now upon, about to enter.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations.
Thank you, Tony. Ken did a lot more research than I thought he would, and I appreciate the Chief Judge for swearing me in. We've actually known each other some 40 years. We've tried cases against each other. And when I walked in this courtroom, which I haven't been into in a long, long time, I recalled that back in those days, I actually tried a case in this courtroom. It was a working courtroom. We had offices over here in Clearwater and tried cases in the new courthouse. And we still tried some here. And Senator Latvala, the reason you haven't been invited to one of these before is we haven't had one before. This is the first one. And I haven't had a swearing in since 1993, as the Chief Judge mentioned. None of those years would have been possible without my lovely wife, Denise, who you just met. Her support has been critical to any success that I have had. But anyway, other than Janet Long, I didn't get permission to speak very long. So I won't. Let me bring up Bob Dillinger, his wife Kay, and again, our esteemed Chief Judge, Tony Rondolino, to administer the oath to our public defender, who has been in office since 1997. And he served as an assistant public defender for many years before that, as well as serving clients in the private sector. Bob is well respected around the state. In fact, he is the current president of the Florida Public Defenders Association. So he will be bothering you a lot in Tallahassee this year, senators. So with that, Chief Judge Rondolino, would you administer the oath to Mr. Dillinger?
Raise your right hand, please. I state your name.
I, Bob Dillinger.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support, protect, and defend.
That I will support, protect, and defend.
The Constitution and government of the United States.
The Constitution and the government of the United States.
And of the state of Florida.
And of the state of Florida.
That I am duly qualified to hold office.
That I am duly qualified to hold office.
Under the Constitution of the state.
Under the Constitution of the state.
And that I will well and faithfully perform.
And that I will well and faithfully perform.
The duties of the public defender of the Sixth Judicial Circuit.
The duties of the public defender for the Sixth Judicial Circuit.
On which I am now about to enter.
On which I am now about to enter.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations, Scott.
Thank you.
When I was an assistant public defender, my chief assistant public defender was Judge Rondolino. He was not a judge then, but he was the chief assistant, and we tried cases together. When I got elected in 97, I was sworn in by Judge Rondolino, and now on my last term as public defender for the Sixth Judicial Circuit, I'm honored that he swore me in first and last. I will be brief. It's an honor to have served the people of Pinellas County, the Sixth Judicial Circuit. The level of the quality of justice in this circuit is unmatched statewide. I've been statewide. We have a group, particularly in Pinellas County, that works so well together, whether it's our legislative delegation, whether it's our county commissioners, whether it's our fellow judges, the state attorney, the public defenders. We accomplish a lot in this county that other counties do not. But I want to echo what Pam Dubov said. There are people that do not have power. There are people who are poor. There are people who are minorities. And this county and this state, and I hope this country, recognizes the last phrase of the Pledge of Allegiance. We've recognized it here in Pinellas. We constantly fight for it, and that phrase is with liberty and justice for all. So it's been an honor. I appreciate it. Thank you for letting me serve.
Thank you, Bob. Well stated. Let me get my pages here. All right. I get my glasses on for this one. Ken Burke and crowd. Coming up with our clerk is Cecilia Burke, his wife, Patrick Burke, son, Ashley Burke, daughter-in-law, Brendan Burke, son, parents, Dolores and Ray French, sister and brother-in-law, Colleen and Joe Sweeney, and his campaign treasurer, Cheryl Bowman. Ken has been the clerk since 2005. I remember his election, and we will all remember the tagline, Burke for clerk. It came true then, and is still true today. And let me invite our esteemed senator back up, Senator Latvala, to administer the oath.
Burke for clerk. I'm going to keep my phrases a little shorter. Please place your left hand on the Bible, raise your right hand, repeat after me. I, Ken Burke, do solemnly swear that I will support, protect, and defend the Constitution and government of the United States and of the state of Florida. That I am duly qualified to hold office under the Constitution of the state, and that I will well and faithfully perform the duties of the Pinellas County Clerk of the Circuit Court and Comptroller. On which I am now about to enter. So help me God.
All right.
I wanted to make sure we had an audience here tonight, so I had all my family members attend. I'm obviously very, very grateful to my family. All of us who hold elective office will be thanking our family because we can't do the job without our family's support. I am especially grateful to my wife, Cecilia, my beautiful wife, Cecilia, and to my children, Patrick and Brendan, and my daughter, Catherine, who is up in Washington, D.C. My daughter, Catherine, is a marshal's aide in the United States Supreme Court.
And I'm very proud of her for that. The day after MLK Day, she'll be standing behind the justices as the eight justices will be going about their work hearing oral arguments. And I'm very proud of my sons, Patrick and Brendan, too, for being just great people and have great hearts. I want to thank all of you and the people of Pinellas County for the faith that you've put in me as clerk of the court. But especially I want to take this moment to thank the staff, the very dedicated and hardworking staff of the clerk's office. Government workers get a bad rap. They really do. When I got elected clerk, the thing that impressed me the most was the supreme dedication of the staff of the clerk's office. And I witness it in throughout Pinellas County government, but people are truly dedicated to the mission that we have. And they really are unsung heroes. I say some of our supervisors in the clerk's office, the building may be on fire, and they would make sure they preserve their work and save their work before they left their station. That's the type of dedication that they have. People don't realize, but the clerk's office, like the state attorney, the public defender, the judiciary, and the sheriff's office, we work 365 days a year. We have people staffing our office, administering justice and making sure that the people's wills are being served. And our dedication of the employees is in their knowledge that they have. In the clerk's office, we have over 1,000 statutes which direct us something to do, whether it's the value adjustment board, which we monitor, or the records responsibility we have and as custodian of all the county commission's records, or the finance responsibilities of paying the bills and staying with the Prompt Payment Act, or administering the grants which come to the county, or a court responsibility. And let me tell you, the intricacies, whether it be a traffic citation or first degree murder, the detail which has to go into each, and bond forfeitures, and you go on. There's no possible one person in the clerk's office who has the knowledge to run the office, to have the knowledge of every aspect. We rely on subject matter experts. People, you remember this, Judge Arizari, we would call people in our office, people with high school diplomas, who would be an expert on foreclosure law, probably better than any foreclosure attorney in Pinellas County, and can quote every part of the statute from A to Z and tell you how everything's administered and regulated as far as that foreclosure sale. And it's so impressive. So my hat's off to the supreme effort of government workers, especially those in Pinellas County, and especially those I work with in the Pinellas County Clerk of the Court's office. Thank you.
Well, we finally get to somebody new. Somebody that actually had an opponent. And by the way, Mike, the way we did it is a lot easier. So, anyway, the next honoree is Mike Twitty. He was elected in this past November. He will come up with his wife, Michelle, his son, Zach, Samuel, and his parents, Tom and Linda Twitty. Jim Stack will come up and administer the oath of office. Mike, you have the shoes are big, but they're on small feet.
Yes.
You have to replace. So.
Now I don't have anything to talk about. You just told me.
Oh, I'm sorry. It's my first time.
Yeah.
Mine too. Please place your left hand on the Bible and raise your right hand and repeat after me. I, state your name.
I, Mike Twitty.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support, protect, and defend.
That I will support, protect, and defend.
The Constitution and government.
The Constitution and government.
Of the United States and of the state of Florida.
Of the United States and of the state of Florida.
That I am duly qualified to hold office.
That I am duly qualified to hold office.
Under the Constitution of the state.
Under the Constitution of the state.
And that I will well and faithfully perform.
And I will well and faithfully perform.
The duties of Pinellas County property appraiser.
The duties of Pinellas County Property Appraiser.
On which I am now about to enter.
On which I am now about to enter.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Well, thank you. Yes, this is my first time, so. And I need to re-recognize Valerie Fuzz for her amazing job, and I will never sing again after hearing her. She was remarkable. And you did not need a microphone in this great acoustic venue here. I feel very, very blessed and fortunate to serve the people of Pinellas County. I see many smiling faces in this room that were very strong supporters of mine, too many to name, but believe me, you'll get my love one-on-one. Could not have done it without you all. A few people that I would really like to recognize, obviously my family, Michelle, my lovely wife, Michelle. She's been at my side through this whole process. You know, before, during, and after a campaign can be trying at times, and she did a remarkable job, as well as my two sons, Zachary and Samuel. My parents, Tom and Linda, were right there and rolled up their sleeves and hopped right in. So can't thank them enough. Love you all. And then a few dignitaries here that also helped out big on the campaign trail. I have to, my appreciation of Senator Brandis, Pam Dubov, of course, and Ken Burke. Thank you very much for your help. I could not be here without them. And Pam, yes, you do have large shoes to fill, but they are on small feet, as Bernie said. So I will do my best to take care of your people. I know you love them dearly, and they're like family, and I will treat them as such. And I promise you that I will continue to try and follow in your footsteps and lead an exemplary office and continue the level of excellence that you've set down there. And we'll continue to move forward, make Pinellas as great a county as there is in this state. And I look forward to serving you all. Thank you very much. Thanks for being here.
You know, there's two pieces of mail that most people in Pinellas County don't want to see. I've been told that when they see an envelope with my return address on it, they don't want to open it either. But either the first or second most despised piece of mail comes from the tax collector. And of course, Diane Clark is unable to be here with us today. And something else you need to know. And Charles Thomas has been referred to as Carlos several times today. And most of us in the room have known him as Carlos. He advised me before this ceremony that his real name is Charles, and Carlos is a nickname. So from henceforth, we will refer to him as Charles. And when you get the bill in the mail, the check will be made out to Charles Thomas. Charles was elected to office in November, and again, he ran a dream campaign. He avoided being on the ballot. Patty Thomas, his wife, will join him. Christy Foley, his daughter, and Bill Foley, his son-in-law. And Miriam Irizarry will administer the oath of office. Come up, Charles, please.
Carlos. I know you by Carlos. But I'm so proud of you. Point of personal privilege here.
Yes, ma'am.
We both worked together as chief deputies, and we had the pleasure and the honor of working under two wonderful public servants, Ken Burke and Diane Nelson, and you know, the tradition of excellence in public service. I know that that is something that you're very committed to, and I know you stand ready to serve the people of Pinellas County, and I'm just so proud of you.
Thank you.
All right, so please place your left hand on the Bible and raise your right hand and repeat after me. I, Charles Thomas.
I, Charles Thomas.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support, protect, and defend.
That I will support, protect, and defend.
The Constitution and government.
The Constitution and government.
Of the United States.
Of the United States.
And the state of Florida.
And the state of Florida.
And that I am duly qualified.
And that I am duly qualified.
To hold office.
To hold office.
Under the Constitution of the state.
Under the Constitution of the state.
And that I will well and faithfully perform.
And that I will well and faithfully perform.
The duties of Pinellas County tax collector.
The duties of Pinellas County tax collector.
On which I am now about to enter.
On which I am now about to enter.
So help me God.
So help me God. And please, as Bernie said, make those checks out to Charles W. Thomas. It has to be a legal signature. The journey that brought me to this point today started a little more than 16 years ago while having dinner with Diane Nelson. And she asked me two questions of that dinner. First was, will you serve as my chief deputy? And second, will you consider running for office someday? I enjoyed 16 years serving with Diane as her chief deputy, and there isn't a better public servant this county has ever known than Diane. And I am very honored today to begin my service as Pinellas County tax collector. Now, Diane was a lot more than my boss. She was a dear friend, she was a great mentor, and a visionary leader. And so I know one of my charges is to carry that forward, and that is my intention. I'm blessed to have family here with me tonight. The support of my family has been huge. My beautiful wife, Patty, I am much of what I am today because of her. My daughter and son-in-law, Christy and Bill Foley, are here. And I know my son, Josh, and my daughter, Amy, are up in Savannah watching this live stream, I think on Facebook. So hello out there. It was wonderful to have the support. And I have dear friends here and people in the community that supported me. And it meant a lot. I want to thank you. Thank you all for being there for me all these years, and thank you for being here tonight. Bernie mentioned that I had a dream campaign, and he's right. It was short and it was unopposed. And I want to thank the people that I think are most responsible for that. And that's the folks who are part of the Pinellas County Tax Collector Organization. It's their dedication to and passion for public service that has built the reputation that the office that I'm going to hold has, and that is one of excellent customer service every single day. It made it easy for people to want to continue that journey and give me the opportunity to serve. So for those, my folks out there, and I know you're all there and I can't see you through the lights, thank you so much. We're going to enjoy doing this together. I'm proud to be your tax collector. Thank you all. Good night.
Next and last, but certainly not least, the person that ensures that all of us stay in office. The one who counts the votes.
Don't blame me.
And I kind of agree with Senator Latvala. Too many darn absentee ballots. I know, boo. Deb Clark has been our supervisor of elections since 2000 and done a remarkable job of not having a single Chad in this county. No scandal, not too many recounts. And Deb's husband, Richard Clark, will come up with her, and Phil Clark, her son, will come up. Richard? Or no? Oh, there he is. Okay. And Richard will, or Phil Clark, will swear in. Okay.
Okay. She's giving me direction.
Something new.
I need it. Please place your left hand on the Bible and raise your right hand and repeat after me. I, Deborah Clark.
I, Deborah Clark.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support.
That I will support.
Protect.
Protect.
And defend the Constitution.
And defend the Constitution.
And government of the United States.
And government of the United States.
And the state of Florida.
And the state of Florida.
That I am duly qualified.
That I am duly qualified.
To hold office.
To hold office.
Under the Constitution of the state.
Under the Constitution of the state.
And that I will well and faithfully perform.
And that I will well and faithfully perform.
The duties of the Pinellas County Supervisor of Elections.
The duties of the Pinellas County Supervisor of Elections.
On which I am now about to enter.
On, say it again.
On which I am now about to enter.
On which I am now about to enter.
So help me God.
So help me God. I promise. What a special evening. My thanks to Ken Burke for making us realize how important this is and for doing all the heavy lifting to make this happen. Thank you, Ken. I hope you notice that I am the only female at this table. I think it should also be noted I am last on the program and that I have a very long memory. Today I was thinking about someone very special, Judge Patrick Cadell. He chaired the election canvassing boards, for more than 20 years and swore me in for my first four terms of office. Pat was my close friend and mentor, and I miss him every day. To my staff, thank you for your dedication and your tireless efforts. This job looks easy from 30,000 feet, but I guarantee you it is very complex, it's very challenging, and there are a lot of moving parts. Thank you all for being here tonight. To my son, Phil, and he definitely knows how I feel about him, thank you for I must say, I respect all of Phil's accomplishments, but I think more important to me is the special person he is, how much he does for others, and that he has an amazing heart. He's a very generous person, and I love him. To my husband, Richard, who is truly the love of my life, thank you for your support and your encouragement. Before we were married, Richard told me, he said, if something is important to you, it will be important to me. And I thought, yeah, right. But for 32 years, he has kept his promise. And to all the voters and the citizens of Pinellas County, I promise you, I will do my very best for you, and I will do all I can to protect your right to vote. Thank you.
A couple things before we leave. I just want to follow up on something Bob Dillinger said, and I hope you can see it from the attitudes of the various public officials here. We genuinely get along. And as Bob mentioned, and I've been all around the state prosecuting cases on assignments from the governor, and you don't find this everywhere. Everybody likes to think that the grass is greener on the other side of the fence. Well, we are the green grass in Pinellas County. We collaborate together. We have a collegial atmosphere. Very rarely do we get angry at each other. I only get angry at the legislature when they don't give my employees raises and they can't pay off their student loans. But that's beside the point. They're not local officials. But we genuinely do get along here. And that's something you don't find everywhere else. A couple of acknowledgments. First of all, I would like us to recognize once again Valerie Fuzz for her national anthem. Thank you. And secondly, I'd like us to give an acknowledgement to Ken Burke and his staff for putting this together, getting all the printing done. I can't imagine it being any more professional than Ken planned it. So Ken, thank you very much. To our esteemed senators, thank you for gracing us with your presence and your wise words. And with that, we're adjourned.